Hello psychics and welcome to Learn Tarot with me for free. Today I'm doing an overview of the wands in the minor arcana. So we're going to go through each card and we're going to really tune into what they mean. So thank you for being here, for liking, subscribing and all the amazing comments, feedbacks and donations. It means the world, as you know. So I've spoke about how every single thing in the tarot tells a story. And when I finished the major arcana, I did an overview of the majors and about the story it creates. And I'm going to do the same with each suit of cards, because you know, they do tell a story. And when you understand the story, it makes it so much easier to read tarot, because you feel the cards and you really feel that they are a part of you. And these cards feel like the other part of me. So I want you to feel that passion and that vigor for your cards, because when you really tune into them in that way, nothing can stop you. You know, you feel it, you know it. Tarot becomes a part of you and you just love what you do. You love connecting with them, and every deck of tarot you pick up will mean something new and amazing to you. So the suit of wands then, the fire suit, we know it's connected with the fire element, the fire signs, and we know that it's all about work, career, passion, projects, action, bringing great things in. So this is the overview then, straight from heaven, straight from the angels, from Archangel Raziel, Archangel Uriel and Archangel Gabriel. Thank you for being with me. So the Ace of Wands then, this means passion, fire, newness coming in, opportunities, everything starting to fall into place. Great things are ahead. The drive inside of you to start something new. So the Ace of Wands means great things coming in. Passion, fire, holding the Olympic torch, preparing to take action on something new. Decisions may be coming in and you may be being guided to move forward. Usually from March time. So around March, something will really spark within you to make these changes. And then it brings you to a crossroads. It brings you to a crossroads with the Two of Wands, where you are facing a decision. Which path do you take? What do? You follow your gut instinct. You follow your heart. You may need to take a risk like the Fool in the tarot and go for what is guiding you in the right direction. So there's two paths you can take. Where do you go? You go towards action. You go towards passion and purpose and what makes your heart sing. And then in the Three of Wands, you've made that decision. You've made the decision, you've chose your path, and it's leading you forward towards the path of peace. Progress has been made. You're ready. You're really observing everything now, because you know that the world is your oyster and you've got the world at your feet here. And then we get the Four of Wands. So greatness coming in within relationships, building something new, holiday times, fresh starts. Everything feels good because you're building something, you're moving towards something now, and it's a time for family, for relationships, for having some fun, for really enjoying yourself, because you've created wonderful things here. And then the Five of Wands may bring a bit of conflict in, fighting with the ego, fighting with others, but they're just ridiculous things that go round and round and round in circles. It's things that don't really mean anything, and you have to kind of take a step back and see the truth. And the truth is that, you know, only love is real and only purpose is real. Take a move forward. Don't worry about the small stuff. The angels are saying don't sweat the small stuff, because victory is coming in. Feeling good, promotion, power, pats on the back, recognition, success. Everything you've been working to is falling into place. And you may need to defend it with the Seven of Wands. You may need to stand up for yourself a little bit and speak the truth, because the closing throat chakra. But ultimately, it will bring great power in. And with great power comes great responsibility. So standing up for what you believe in, defending what you've created, because you've created wonderful things here now. And because of that, things are moving forward. Things are moving forward, things you're creating. End to setback and delays. Forward motion on things, travel maybe. You know, forward motion, momentum. But don't give up. You know, don't give up if things aren't falling into place. Don't give up. Keep moving forward. Keep striving forward. keep focusing on the end result, even when there's burdens and responsibilities and you feel like you can't go on or you can't carry it another day. Just ask the angels for help. Ask heaven's assistance, the universe. Know that you're not alone. And that's when great opportunities will flow in. Things will start to flow in, good news, opportunities, maybe people that can help you. And then you stand in your power, because everything you're creating is falling into place. Well, they show me the Queen of Wands and the Knight of Wands. So, you know, everything is falling into place with the Knight of Wands. You know, you're moving forward now fearlessly. And then this energy comes in. So they show me all these are pretty much the same thing, because the Knight of Wands is the action forward. Things falling into place, momentum, great things ahead. Sometimes it can mean October as well, or autumn time, as things really starting to unfold. And then you are standing in your power as the Queen and King of Wands here. So action. So great things are falling into place, you know. So when you deal with this suit here, know that it's all about action, following your heart, but your passion as well, what you're passionate about. The Wands is more about passion and fire and drive and dedication and moving towards a cause and creating things than anything else. I hope this helped, and we'll be back with the amazing Ace of Swords. I'll see you soon.